Oh, hello there. Now, most people can probably tell you that sound is measured in decibels or dB. But where that comes from and how they work is an interesting story that is little known and less understood. You may have heard of Alexander Graham Bell, who was the first person to hold a patent for the telephone, which he went on to successfully develop and later founded the Bell Telephone Company in 1877, which eventually became AT&T. As part of this enterprise, Bell Telephone Laboratories was created, which is now Nokia Bell Labs, and is still heavily involved in telephony research today. Alexander Graham Bell was very interested in acoustics, hearing, and speech, and did much work in these areas throughout his life. Because of this association, when Bell Labs invented a scale for handling the measurement of transmission loss and power in telephony systems, they named it the Bell scale in his honour. As signals are often very small, it is more common to use tenths of a bell, or decibels, which can be used to express many things in engineering, including sound pressure levels. These would otherwise be measured in pascals, the unit for pressure, which was coined in the 17th century by Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, physicist, inventor, philosopher, writer, and Catholic theologian. The reason for introducing this scale was to handle very large signal ranges in a scale that is readable and contains information about the energy contained within that signal. This was done by using a logarithmic scale to base 10, or log 10. So instead of the numbers increasing in increments of 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc., the numbers increase in factors of 10, in this case 1, 10, 100, 1000, and so on. The result of this strange scale is that a sound pressure increase of 3 dB actually represents a doubling of energy. So a seemingly small increase in decibels can mean a huge increase in sound. This is further complicated by the fact that humans cannot perceive increases in sound in terms of energy, and it takes around 10 decibels for a human ear to perceive the sound to have doubled. Who said perception was everything? There is lots of maths you can do behind all this to understand what is going on. But the takeaway message is that the decibel level you might see on a sound meter must be viewed in this context. If you see a level increase from 93 to 96 decibels, for example, that is twice the sound and therefore twice the damage to your hearing. So think twice before cranking up the dial on your home hi-fi, as dBs are not all they seem to be. Stay safe and have fun. Bye.